Hi everyone, in the previous part of placenta development we have seen how the blastocyst implants itself in the endometrial lining, and as it does, what is forming? The endometrial lining is now termed to be decidua because it is shed off at the time of childbirth. Now in this part we are going to see how the chorionic villi, that is primary, secondary or tertiary, forms, and as this forms the placenta is develops. And along with that, we'll also see that how the umbilical cord as well as the fetal membrane, that is amnion and chorion, is formed. So before that, we'll draw the figure of the uterus. And here it is the fundal part. So, in my previous lectures, I have told you that there are the three layers of the uterus. The outermost lining is called the perimetrium, and the middle one is called the myometrium, that is made up of muscles, and the innermost lining is called the endometrium. And in the innermost lining, again, there are the two linings. One is the basal layer, that is the stratum basalis, and the another one is the functional layer, this whole lining. And in the functional layer too, there are again two layers, that is, one is compact layer and the another is spongy layer. So the implantation which is going to take place is in the functional layer of the endometrium, that is shed off at the time of childbirth. The basal layer is not involving in the implantation process. Now this is the blastocyst, and in the blastocyst the inner mononucleated layer is called the cytotrophoblast. This is the cytotrophoblast, and the outer lining of this trophoblast, that is the multinucleated layer which helps in the penetration of this endometrial lining, and this multinucleated layer is called the sensual trophoblast. So what is happening here? These sensual trophoblastic layers creates some spaces within them. As these cells expands, what is happening? They create some spaces, and these are forming all around this whole structure. But majorly it is forming in this embryonic pole. So here you can see the interstitial implantation is completed, and these sensual trophoblastic layers forming the finger-like projections. They are forming finger-like projections in between these spaces. And these spaces, that is the lacunae, these spaces called the lacunae, and these lacunae finally merge to form the lacunar network here. These are merging and forming the lacunar network, and few of the sensual trophoblastic cells erode some of the maternal capillaries. Few of the cells erode these maternal capillaries, and as these erodes these linings, what is happening? The maternal blood draining inside these lacunar spaces. This maternal blood draining inside these lacunar spaces. So here it is, the spaces are filling with this maternal blood, and this is very important structure. Later on, this lacunar spaces are finally called the intervillous space. because these are the spaces which are present in between these finger-like projection, that is the villi. So these are called intervillar spaces later on. So as the structure is formed, that is the finger-like projection of sensitoblasts, with this surrounding lacunar spaces are called the trabeculae, the trabecule. So what is trabecule? That is these cord-like structure of the sensitoblast surrounded by these lacunar spaces, and these lacunar spaces later on form the intervillous space. So this type of villi system is not forming in this embryonic pole itself, whereas it is forming all around the blastocyst, but prominently it is forming or well developed in this embryonic pole. It is less developed around this embryonic pole. Now what is happening in this embryoblast? There is bilaminar disc is formed, and these bilaminar disc, that is one from the epiblast, here it is the epiblast, and these surround to form a cavity, and it forms the amniotic cavity later on. And this is the hypoblast, and these hypoplastic cells cover this inner lining of the trophoblast and forms the another cavity, and this is the yolk sac, primary yolk sac. Now what is happening in the end of second week? These yolk sac or the hypoblastic cells forms, these forms some cells around whole of the embryoblast, around this yolk sac as well as the amniotic cavity, it means the whole of this embryoblast. This hypoplastic cells forming some type of cell in between this embryoblast and this cytotroblast, and these are called the extra embryonic mesoderm. So from where it is forming? It is formed from this hypoblast cell, and this surrounds the whole of this embryoblast and separate this structure to this cytotroblast. Now what is happening here is that soon there is degradation of these mesodermal cells, and they become rearranged themselves in the periphery. They become rearranged themselves in the periphery as well as in the inner aspect of this blastocyst, which is covering this embryoblast. So later on, these mesodermal cells become degenerate and they become rearranged and forms a cavity within these two layer, and this cavity now it is termed to be extraembryonic coelom. Extraembryonic coelom. Coelom means the cavity. So it forms the extraembryonic coelom, the cavity. Later on, this cavity forms the coronic cavity. So these mesodermal cells become degenerate here, but it creates a band of tissue. But here it creates a band of tissues which connect this embryoblast with this cytotrophoblast. So these band of tissues are called the connecting stalk or the body stalk. So these band of mesodermal tissues, that is formed from extraembryonic mesoderm, which connect this embryoblast to this cytotrophoblast, forms the connecting stalk. Later on, this connecting stalk change into the umbilical cord. Now at 13th day, what is happening? These cytotrophoblastic layer, this cytotrophoblastic layer enters into these villi. What is happening? the cytotrophoblastic layer enters into this villi. So as these enters into this villi of cytotrophoblastic layer, these are forming the primary villi. So what is primary villi? That is the projection of these cytotrophoblastic layer into the cytotrophoblastic layer. So outer one is the cytotrophoblastic layer, that is the blue one, and when it is covered internally by the cytotrophoblastic layer, that is called the primary villi, and it is formed by the day of 13. Now after that, what is happening? These mesodermal, that is extra embryonic mesodermal linings, finally enters into this villi. What is happening here? These mesodermal lining is now entering inside these finger like projection. Here it is there. And as these enters into this villus system, by the 16th day, these are forming the secondary villi. So what is secondary villi? When these extra embryonic mesodermal lining enters into these finger like projection, which is covered by the cytotrophoblast, and that is covered by the cytotrophoblast. So when these lining enters into this finger like projection, that forms the secondary villi. Now the primary villi is formed, and then secondary villus is also formed here. Now after that, what is happening? Few of these extra embryonic mesodermal linings differentiate into the capillaries, that is the villus capillaries. So what is happening? These mesodermal linings forming the capillaries, that is the villus capillaries, into these finger like projection. So as these capillaries are formed, that is the blood vessels are formed within this finger like projection, then it is called the tertiary villi, and the formation which is going to take place here is on the day 21st. So what are the tertiary villi? That is, the outermost lining is covered by the cytotrophoblastic layers, that is the blue one. Then it is covered by the cytotrophoblast, that is the black one. Then it is covered by the mesodermal linings, and finally these mesodermal linings encircles the villus capillaries, and as this structure is formed, this finger like structure is formed with this whole linings, that is called the tertiary villi. Now at the same time, what is happening? Few of the cytotrophoblastic cells penetrate this cytotrophoblastic layer and align themselves transversely. They migrate transversely and covers this cytotrophoblastic layer by a shell. So this is how these cytotrophoblastic cells penetrating the cytotrophoblastic cells and covering them transversely. So as these cells goes transversely, what is happening? They covers the outer lining of cytotrophoblast and form the cytotrophoblastic shell here. What is forming here? Cytotrophoblastic shell. So here it is forming the cytotrophoblastic shell. So the cells which are penetrating this cytotrophoblastic cells, they tightly anchored with this decidual lining. So these are called the anchoring villi. That is, they anchored to this decidua basalis. That is this structure. So this is the decidua basalis. And few of the cytotrophoblastic cells do not penetrate. Few of the cytotrophoblastic cells do not penetrate, and they are called the nutritive villi because they are not anchored till this decidua basalis. So these are called nutritive villi. The cells which penetrating these cinctioblastic cells and goes beyond that and anchored with this decidua basalis, these called the anchoring villi, and which do not process, they called nutritive villi. Now this type of villi system is forming all around this blastocyst, but I am forming here only. Why? Because later on, as the structure, that is the embryo, or later on the fetus grows more and more, the villi which are lying toward this decidua capsularis, this is the decidua basalis, because it lying toward the base of the blastocyst, that this part is called the decidua capsularis. So the villi which are lying toward the decidua capsularis become atrophied, and as they become atrophied, what is forming here, as this villus system by these three layers, that is the mesenchymal layer, cytoblast and the cinctioblast, this become atrophied, and the combination of these three linings finally forms a thin layer which is called the chorionic leaf. And this is formed by the end of third month, and this chorionic leaf later on forms the outer lining of the fetal membrane. Fetal membrane, that is the chorion. Chorion is formed from chorionic leaf by the fusion of the chorionic villi which are lying toward this decidua capsularis. The fetus also grows inside, and the inner lining of this fetus, that is the fetal membrane, is called the amnion. This lining is called, forms the amnion, that is the inner lining of fetal membrane, and the outer one is called the chorion. So this is how these two fetal membranes are formed, and later on the few cells in these connecting band, that is the connecting stalk, become degenerate and forms the cord like structure here, that is called the umbilical cord. Initially these are the finger like projections, but later on what is happening, these become more branching like this. The cinctioblastic layer become more branching here, and inner is covered by the cytoblastic layers, and inner to that is the mesodermal linings. Here are the extra embryonic mesodermal lining, and inner to that is the fetal capillaries. So they forms the branching network. So this will be easy for the exchange of nutrient and waste material between the mother and the fetus, because the surface area becomes larger. So these finger like projections later on forms the branching network. So in a well developed placenta, there is one basal plate. Here it is, this is the basal plate, and this basal plate is formed by the decidua basalis, and it is formed by the layers of cytoblastic shell, cinctioblast and cytoblast, that is this whole layer is called the basal plate, and the another one is the chorionic plate, that is this part, in which there is the extra embryonic mesoderm. Then there is a, here you can see, there is a layer of extra embryonic mesoderm, then is the cytoblast, and then is the cinctioblast. So this is how this chorionic plate is formed, and there is formed the basal plate, and in between these two plates there are the well developed chorionic villi. So in this placenta, the majority of the portion is formed from the fetus, because these chorionic plate as well as this villus system is originate from the fetal part, and 1/5 part is originate from the mother. That is the part of this decidua basalis, and the blood which is coming from these maternal capillaries, and this blood enters into this intervillous space. So the blood which is in intervillous space as well as the lining of this decidua basalis is of maternal origination. Remaining whole part of the placenta, that is 4/5 part, is from the fetus origination. So the fetal origination part from this chorionic plate, these villi are called the chorion frondosum. That is called the chorion frondosum. Chorion frondosum, that is the chorionic plate, and the villi which are extending from these plate are called the chorion frondosum. That is from the fetal origination. And the remaining part is formed from this decidua basalis and the blood from these maternal capillaries. So in this video we have seen how the functional unit of the placenta, that is the villi, primary, secondary and tertiary villi are formed, and along with that how the fetal membrane, that is the inner one is amnion and the outer one is chorion, is formed and the umbilical cord develops. Thank you.